This is an Ender 3. It's been part of my print farm, and it has a lot of printing hours on it. But recently, it's been giving me prints that are weak and also some under extrusion. And I've had some blockage that I've had to clear. Well, it turns out the PTFE tube is wore out and needs to be replaced. So I'll show you what to look for and how to replace it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. To show you the issue, I have to take the PTFE tubing out. In order to do that, I got to get the filament out. So first thing I have to do is preheat the hot end. Now I can take out the filament. I'll push out just a little bit and then pull it back. Now, normally I'd take it all the way out, but I'm only going to take it out partially to show you where it's blocking. And while it's still warm, I'm going to take the coupling out so I can pull the PTFE tubing away from the nozzle. So you just loosen it with the wrench, and that wrench comes with your Ender 3. And then I finish it off with my fingers, and once it's loose enough, I should be able to pull this right out. And there we go. If we look closely, you can see there's filament stuck in there, and it's stuck tight. I couldn't push it out with the filament. Now, normally what I could do here is just come in with the tool, the cutters from Capricorn, and just clip that end off and put it back together. But I found there was another issue. When I was pushing in the filament, I would get to a certain point, and I would feel I was hitting. And I realized it wasn't going all the way to the end. It was actually stopping at the coupling. So there's something inside this coupling causing the filament to stop. So we need to take this coupling off or slide it up. So I'm gonna push it down on the lock, and pull it up, and there's a big gouge here, huge gouge. And when I pulled the filament back and then wiggled this thing, I could feel that it was cracked. So it's cracked or cut all the way through, and this is what the filament was hitting. So this PTFE tube is bad. It needs to be replaced. Even cutting that off, it's going to be too short. That cut was causing issues. I was getting stringing that was affecting the retraction. So it was more than just, you know, a block nozzle. There was bad prints coming because of this cut. So I'm going to replace everything. I'm going to replace the PTFE tubing, and I'm going to replace the couplings, because the couplings from Creality are not the best. And the PTFE tubing I've got has new couplings. So I need to cut the tie straps off away from the wiring. Then I need to remove the filament the rest of the way. And then I'm going to take this final coupling off. And this one's just hand tightened because I loosen it all the time to feed filament in. So I can just hand loosen that. Now I'll just set this aside because the only reason I need this is to measure the new PTFE tubing. I'm going to replace it with authentic Capricorn PTFE tubing, and this kit comes with a tool to cut it and two sets of couplings, and then the locks for the coupling, along with enough PTFE tubing to do this more than once. Now, mine looks a little bit different here. It's a different color because this is a special set that they gave me for Filament Friday. It's all the same couplings and everything. It's just a little bit different tubing. It's a red tubing, which is what I love. I love the red tubing. So that's what I'm going to use. But other than that, it's the same high temperature PTFE tubing, same cutter, same couplings. So the next step is to take the old PTFE tubing, assuming you haven't cut that end off too many times, and measure out the right length. And I'm going to cut it just above the top of the coupling that went into the extruder bracket. So just cut it nice and flat. And now I can double check the length. And then I'll set this old tubing aside to be thrown out. Now I'll take out two couplings, one small and one large, and set the other ones aside. And then the first step is to take that small coupling and push it onto the PTFE tubing. Now I can tell already these are better. They go on tight, but if I push the clip, they come right off. So just push it on until it stops. And now we need to install it on the hot end. So the trick that I use is I put the coupling on top of the fan, and then I push the tubing in until it hits the nozzle. And then right at the top of where the wrench would go, I put a mark with a magic marker. And you want a permanent marker, it's going to rub off, but it's only has to be there long enough to see it. So there's the mark, and I'm going to use that as reference. Now I'll take the coupling, and I'm going to screw it all the way into the hot end. You can do most of it by hand, and then I'll finish it off with a wrench. But take it all the way until it stops, until it's almost tight. And then I'm going to use the wrench to just give it one more turn to make sure I'm tight. And then I'm going to back it off 3/4 of a turn. So just three turns here with the wrench. And now I can push the PTFE tubing, and I want it to go all the way down to the nozzle. That's why I did that first step. So if I push on the coupling lock, push this down until it hits the nozzle, you'll see that my mark is right at the top. That way I know I've gone far enough. Now I take the wrench and I tighten it back those three turns, and this crunches the PTFE tubing down against the nozzle, which is what you want. The next step is to install the coupling into the extruder bracket, and this should fit nicely. The threads feel really good, nice and smooth, and it goes right in. So I just hand tighten these. I don't use a wrench on this because I'm going to have to take it back off at some point. So now we need to put the tie straps back on. So I push the hot end all the way to the one side, and then I line up the wires and I put one tie strap here. And you want it tight, but not too tight. You know, you want it snug, but you still want that PTFE tube to be able to slide a little bit in there. So then I'll put one in the middle. So it's basically all about the same spot they were originally. Then I'll put one right down here just outside the coupling. And then once this one's in place, I'll clip the wires onto the little bracket on the extruder and then test it. Go back and forth and make sure you're not feeling any binding or grabbing by that PTFE tubing. And if it feels good, then just clip the tie straps and you're done. Your kit should also have these clips, and they go onto the couplings and they hold the locks in place so they can't be pushed. So that way the PTFE tubing can't accidentally slide out. So I'm going to heat up the hot end again, and I'm going to by hand push filament through the nozzle. And at first I felt some resistance, so there could have been some blockage in the nozzle, and I could have replaced the nozzle as well. But once I pushed a little bit through, I could see it started to flow nice and straight and no stringing. So this looked really good. It looks smooth. I'm ready to go. I like testing it with a bridge because I like to see how smoothly it's coming out, and you can see it's working really well here. This bridge test is printing beautifully. And after I finished printing it, I could see just a little bit of sag in the center. So my cooling was working, the flow was working, everything looked good. So I was happy with the results, so now I can start printing in my print farm. That's a really easy fix, and it's actually an upgrade because the PTFE tubing from Capricorn will work to a higher temperature than the stock PTFE tube that comes with the Ender 3. And I've experienced that it lasts a lot longer based on my machines back here that have been running it since the start. Normally I put this on a machine for my print farm right at the beginning, but I wanted to see how long that original PTFE tubing would last. And it did, it lasted quite a while. I was really surprised. But these couplings are way better. I can just feel that the release works better and they're just smoother. And as I push the filament in, you can just feel there's less resistance. It's much, much smoother than the original PTFE. So overall, I think this is a good upgrade. And if nothing else, it's a great way to fix your Ender 3.